even labor for determining disputes. We also have a big problem insofar as the number of judicial resources are assigned. Last year, the Judicial Service Commission nominated several judges for appointment. The president did not do that which is supposed to do under the Constitution, swearing in, until such a time as the woes and the education that was filed by Adrian Kamoto, that we were told the reasons why those judges did not swear in. Yes, there could be a problem with some of those judges, but is it proper to stop the entire process because of a few judges? And from the information that is already in circulation, we're made to understand that a substantial number of those affected by the claim of want of integrity would be those high court judges who have been elevated to the court of appeal. What is the prudent thing to do in such circumstances, if at all there are complaints of impropriety against these judges? What has to be done is to originate a complaint through the Judicial Service Commission. Let it be interrogated. If it has merit, then the state will have its way. Because if for a fact these judges are not suitable to continue serving as high court judges, why will they be suitable to serve as court of appeal judges? But the stagnation that has arisen as a result of the impasse between the judiciary and the Judicial Service Commission on one hand and the executive is impairing access to justice. And this is something that we need to address as soon as possible. Because if it is not done, we'll continue having the backlog of cases, and we do not know for how long this is going to prevail. And bearing in mind the recent history of the executive insofar as court orders are concerned, it is doubtful whether, even if a court order is made to pay the swearing in of these judges, they will be actually. And it's for that reason, therefore, that the entire Kenyan public must stand firm to ensure that there is obedience of court orders. Steps must be undertaken to ensure compliance. And if the individuals against whom court orders are addressed do not take the necessary action to comply, then we need to pursue it further to ensure that Article 10 of the Constitution as well as Chapter 6 is complied. Let them be declared unsuitable to hold public office. Because there's no reason as to why a state officer takes oath under the Constitution to live and abide by that Constitution, to perform his duties in terms of the Constitution, yet they do not want to comply with the rule of law, yet they do not want to obey court orders. That is a big problem that must be addressed. Well, we're already there because judicial officers have had to lament. In fact, a judge is on record complaining bitterly by stating that court orders have become like babies, where courts are forced to babysit orders made towards ensuring the rule of law, yet those against whom the court orders are directed continue with their business unperturbed. You understand? Therefore, the rule of law has hit us now.
So do you feel there is some kind of an arm of government with the security to the other? Because the executive seems to be downsizing the definition.
Well, all the three arms of government are supposed to be equal, but they are interdependent. They are not completely independent. But it must be understood that the executive holds the cards. The executive has the coercive power. The police power is only exercised by the executive. Money towards budgetary allocation can only be channeled through the executive. So, unless and until the executive performs its role, unless and until vigilance is maintained, which way applies, then any action taken by the other two arms of government, be it the legislature, be it the judiciary, will not come to fruition.